However, she shot 9.9, while Veloso scored 10.3 to relegate Ghosh to the silver medal. Okay, we have Manisha Malhotra, we have Suma Shirur, but we are delighted to be joined from Gold Coast by none other than Mehuli Ghosh. There she is on our screens. Mehuli, nice to see that smile on your face. Congratulations, you're just 17 and you've done what many thought was the impossible. You've gone to the Commonwealth Games and you almost won the gold, but the silver medal nevertheless.
Yeah, thank you so much.
So, when you were shooting that final, when you shot that 10.9, I've covered shooting for 15, 16 years now. I've never seen a shooter shoot a 10.9 on the final shot. So tell me what you were going through when you saw that 10.9. You thought it was over?
For some seconds, I was like, I was working over high inner tens, and it was a 10.9, and it was the last shot of the finals, but I didn't notice the main screen, which was absolutely my fault. I didn't notice that it was a shoot off. So I completely thought that it is over, and then only I realized that there is a shoot off. So again, I settled back.
Okay, you settle back. In a shoot-off, you can't predict anything, Mehuli. But I'm also joined at the moment by Suma Shirur. She's won a gold medal in the pairs event at the 2002 Games. She's also won a silver in these games in 2002 in the individual category. She's an Olympic finalist, a legend of your sport. Suma, Mehuli is online. So first thing is, I think I would request you to say a few words to her on her performance.
I would say, Mehuli, this is just the beginning, and you've lost out on the tie shot today, but all I would say is, you know, thank God this is not the Olympics. It's yet to come, and that's the time when, you know, you have to go all out, and this is a super experience. It's not about technique, it's not about shooting, it was just a little bit about experience, that it's not over till it's over. So you got to stand out there. So I think this is just an experience, but you're ready. You are shooting fantastic. So I would say it's just about learning to be there till the end and moving on. You are a star and you will show it soon.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
It's a steam thank you from her. She probably wants to jump up and down, Suma, after that high praise. But clearly you're following in footsteps of legends, Mehuli. You've had some great shooters like Suma, Anjali, Bhagwat, who've all gone and won these big medals for India. The women's 10 meter air rifle was a very strong event for India. And great to see both you and Apurvi on the podium.
Yeah, absolutely. It was a really good competition here and very interesting finals also. And I really enjoyed it.
Yes, talk me through that final, Mehuli, because initially you took your time to get going, but then after that, once you caught up, a string of high scores, there were 10.7s, 10.6s. Were you looking at the scoreboard or you were just wanting to be very aggressive and to go out there and win the big medal?
No, I was not looking at the scores, which I was and I was not looking on the difference which I was having between the first, second or third. I was just focusing on my basic. I was just focusing on my technique so that I can give my best. I can do my perfect shots. I was just focusing on that. Nothing on scores or nothing regarding medals also.
You know, Manisha, there's a sort of a personal, personal bonding in that sense with Mehuli, because Mehuli is coached by Joydeep Kormakar, someone you know very well, a very dear friend of mine. And I actually went and saw Mehuli shoot last year at the Delhi shooting range. And really remarkable for India to come up with a talent such as young as this, to go there and shoot 10.9 on the final shot. That really shows the poise and the confidence in this champion.
I do believe so. And I think that Joydeep has done a fantastic job. And as Suma says, that now he has to just keep kind of taking it the next step forward. And the Commonwealth Games has always been a shooting party, and these guys have done phenomenal historically in the Commonwealth Games. So now if she just emulates any of the other shooters in her event, I think she'll be okay. But it speaks very highly about this girl, and to be able to go there and shoot such a good shot. I think the last 10.9 we saw in the final shot was Abhinav, wasn't it?
Abhinav was 10.8.
Oh, that was 10.8. Yeah, okay.
Almost there. So one millimeter here and there.
No, but that's okay. I mean, I think that it's I think the whole performance, on so to speak, for somebody so young, has been very, very good. And I do believe that she definitely has the mental makeup for a big games, and that's half the battle.
Yes, that is half the battle. But Mehuli, also talking about your competition today, Apurvi was there with you. She was the defending champion. A lot of attention on her as well. And really, she was in the game. She was leading right up till she got those two nines. So were both of you pretty disappointed when you hugged each other after the match got over?
Yeah, of course. We were like, we hugged each other. We congratulated each other and we were celebrating at that moment. And she was leading the competition in the finals also, and she shot a brilliant score in the qualification, and I was so happy that it was 423.2. It was really high score.
Yes, and tell me, what you had a conversation immediately after the match and before the medal ceremony, you had a conversation with your coach Joydeep Karmakar. What was the conversation? Was there a tear somewhere, or you were just deflated and you wanted someone to cheer you up?
No, not like that. Like, I called him up, and first only he said the congratulations, but the match was not over. I was like, yeah, I'm like, yeah, that was a huge mistake I did. But then he motivated me that it's nothing. You learned something. That's the most important thing. And I totally agree with him that yes, I could learn something which I will remember for my lifetime.
Yeah. You know, Suma Shirur, when you look at this Indian team which has gone to the Commonwealth Games, and you mentioned it on the preview show as well, that you were looking very keenly at how the youngsters are going to perform. We've already had Manu Bhakar taking a gold. Mehuli has now won the silver. There's Anish Bhanwala coming up in the rapid fire pistol as well. It's a huge plus for Indian shooting, because not just do these youngsters raise the bar, they also give you that bench strength where, you know, burnout is an issue in shooting. But now with these shooters showing that at the World Cup in Mexico as well, with the performances, that, you know, you can afford to rest your shooters in key competition as well, and you don't have to send the best team always, because the next generation is good enough.
Yeah, definitely. And our juniors have proved their mettle, and they are fearless, basically. They are young, and, you know, it's sometimes their youth just gives them that edge of being fearless. And I think this is what we see. This is what we saw in Manu Bhakar. This is what we saw in Mehuli today. It was just about, you know, it was just about strategy that gave her the silver. But if she would have held her ground, I'm quite sure it was gold for us today. So they are fearless, and what I really want to appreciate is that the Federation has showed their confidence in the juniors. You know, it's not that otherwise it could also have been that, you know, they're not so experienced to deal with the kind of pressure that they have, that we should have the senior team. But, you know, it also speaks volumes about the Federation in keeping the confidence in our juniors, and I think I would really applaud that. And
yes.
As far as Apurvi is concerned, fantastic score. You know, somewhere my heart just went out to her. It was only the last, it was the last two shots. But as with the new final format, it is a test of your nerves, really. And, you know, it was just the last two shots. But overall, a fantastic score by Apurvi. It
and
was
hang
not
on, Suma, just put that in perspective
title,
for us.
But she
just
held
put
her
that in perspective for us.
You know?
Because, you know, you're talking about someone, you know, people would look back and say, oh, she was the gold medalist, she won the bronze medal. But the score she shot, put that in perspective, 623.2, that would get you into the final of any competition anywhere in the world, be it the Olympic Games, the World Championship, and she would be leading going into that competition.
Absolutely, and I would say that's a world record score. It's super. And to defend your title and come out with an almost world record qualification score in itself shows how fine a shooter Apurvi is, and especially maintaining her form over the last couple of years, over 4 years, and not just maintaining it, actually getting better, is I think a big asset to my air rifle Indian team, I would say. And she's just getting better, and it was just a matter of, you know, holding out your nerves in the finals. So
okay.
This new final format in a way is good for us, but also it's a real test of your nerves.
I would just correct you to say it's also our Indian air rifle team, But Manisha Malhotra, talking about Apurvi Chandela, you know, we saw her at the Rio Olympics. She went in with a lot of, you know, expectations from her. Since then, she's been pretty quiet. But you bounce back in shooting with your scores. And this is the kind of a score which will give her a lot of confidence. I was speaking to her just after her competition and she was telling me that she actually, this is her personal best. She's never shot this even in training. So to do it in competition is absolutely brilliant. Yes, the format doesn't allow you to carry that forward now in shooting, but it just shows that, you know, with the likes of Mehuli, with Apurvi and the other shooters coming up, this is great for Indian shooting.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to Tokyo. I mean, if you have those kind of scores, I should give you a huge amount of confidence going in. And yeah, if you can get a good solid foundation, and which Apurvi also talked to us a lot when we spoke to her when we were working on shooting, is that she needed a good foundation and she needs to now then keep building on that. And yeah, she's a little, I'm a little sad too, as Suma says, for her. I mean, after so much momentum and to go into a final, which really is now a pressure cooker in every shot, it's sad, but it's also a lot of bright spots. I think that she can take a lot out of this. And Diggy, I mean, you know, and how difficult it is in shooting, and a medal is so small margin. So I think any medal she should be proud of and not be that disheartened. And maybe we can work on the finals now and she can start focusing on being a better final shooter before the Asian Games.
Yes, I remember I was there at Rio at the Olympics when Abhinav Bindra, of all people, lost on a tie shoot. But final word to you, Mehuli Ghosh, because Manu Bhakar told me yesterday that after she won the medal, she was treated to an ice cream. You're effectively 16, 17-year-old, both of you. So how did you celebrate? Were you given an ice cream as well?
No, I came back to village. I put my bags down. And then only I heard that I have to go for my doping test. So I ran there for my doping control. And I just came back maybe 20 minutes before.
Okay. So this is the part of the learning curve. Mehuli, I know it's getting pretty late. It's been a long day for you. So enjoy this moment. Enjoy this moment. And congratulations from all of us here for what you have achieved. And also, if you do see Apurvi, we do give her a huge congratulations from all of us. As well, I'll move on because the medal rush has continued for India's weightlifters on day 5 of the Commonwealth Games in Gold Coast, with Pardeep Singh bagging the silver in the men's 105 kg event. Singh was one of the front runners in this weight category, having proved his credentials by winning the gold medal at last year's Commonwealth Championships with a combined lift of 342 kg. Pardeep bettered that tally today by 10 kg, managing a lift of 152 kg in the snatch and 200 in clean and jerk. However, he had to settle for a silver medal as Samoa's Sanele Mao took the gold with a combined lift of 360 kgs. This was not an event in which India had won a medal at the Glasgow Games 4 years ago, but Pardeep's feat has increased the tally of India's weightlifters to 9 medals in 2018, including 5 golds. And India's boxers too continued their impressive start at the Commonwealth Games with two debutants, Gaurav Solanki and Manish Kaushik, both making it through to the quarterfinals of their respective weight categories. Gaurav Solanki, a former silver medalist at the Youth Commonwealth Games and a last-minute inclusion to India's squad for Gold Coast, was up first against Ghana's Akimos Anang Ampia in the men's 52 kg category. It was a mismatch of a contest. The Indian dominated the bout from the start to finish using his superior technique and quick hands to force his opponent on the defensive. Solanki won 5-0 by unanimous points verdict to go within a win of a guaranteed medal. Over in the men's 60 kg, India's Manish Kaushik overcame the challenge of Trinidad and Tobago's Michael Alexander in a 4-0 points verdict, although the bout was closer than the scoreline suggests. Kaushik, who beat the experienced Shiva Thapa at the national championships last year to make the Indian team, was pushed by Alexander. One judge scored the bout as a tie, while the other four gave it to Kaushik, though with differing margins. He will face England's 2017 European Championship bronze medalist, Calum French, in the next round. And finally, a quick wrap of the notable Indian results from athletics today, and promising youngster Tejaswin Shankar has qualified for the finals of the men's high jump event. The 19-year-old broke the national record at the Federation Cup last month, registered a leap of 2.21 meters to finish fifth in his qualifying group. Interestingly, none of the competitors were able to cross the 2.21 mark in qualifying. India's Hima Das has qualified for the semi-finals of the women's 400-meter race. Hima registered a time of 52.11 seconds in her heat, in which she finished third. The other Indian in this event, MR Poovamma, did not make Tuesday's semi-finals. And finally, India's Tejinder Pal Singh Toor will be competing in the men's shot put finals in a short while from now. Tejinder had qualified for the 12-man final yesterday with a throw of 19.19 meters, although his chances of a medal in this event are quite slim. Manisha Malhotra, you know, high jump isn't something India have had much of a history in, but with Tejaswin Shankar reaching the final, I think it needs to be applauded, because for an Indian to reach an athletics final where you have the likes of Jamaica, you have the likes of England, Australia, who consistently win Olympic medals, it's a huge thing to reach a final.
Yeah, I think the Commonwealth Games has a very, very, you know, high level of competition in athletics. And so this is definitely a commendable performance. And yeah, he's young. I mean, he's not that old. And if we can, in athletics, I think that we need to now start being able to be successful step by step. And if we can get the scores and the distances and things like that in games like this and aim for, you know, just getting into the final, then we can start kind of building towards medals and things like that. But we need a really strong foundation. And historically, we've not done very well in the Commonwealth Games in athletics. And
yes,
it's a measurable sport. And I think that we have to keep going forward. But I think very, very proud of this young lad.
Yes, and also, Suma, you know, when you look at the games which will win you Olympic medals, athletics is a sport which has so many Olympic medals at stake, or a World Championship medal. We've only won one World Championship medal, that's Anju Bobby George in 2003. And gymnastics, we came very close. That's the other sport where you can win multiple medals. And for India to emerge as a world power in sport, we need to start winning these big medals, especially athletics.
Yeah, especially, and we, you know, it's about individuals bringing it forward. And like in the Olympics, who thought that, you know, India would be good in gymnastics? And Deepa Karmarkar just kind of came up with it, and suddenly gymnastics, India, it's a different story with gymnastics in the country. So I think similarly, it's about individuals who take the sport ahead until it goes out to the masses. So this is just the beginning, I would say, to this sport, and definitely there'll be more people coming in and joining the league. I'm sure about it.
Okay, just moving on, because India are on the verge of securing their first ever Commonwealth Games gold medal in the badminton mixed team event. Suma and Manisha, I'll come back to you. India are 2-1 up against triple defending champions Malaysia in the competition final. Purely based on rankings, Malaysia have a much stronger doubles contingent as compared to India. But the mixed doubles pairing of Satwik, Ranki Reddy and Ashwini Ponnappa, they shocked the Olympic silver medalists Chan Peng Soon and Guo Liu Ying, 21-14, 15-21, 21-15. To get India off to a flyer. And after that, the big result. World number 2, Kidambi Srikanth, gave India a 2-0 lead with his first career win against the legend Lee Chong Wei in the men's singles. Srikanth won in straight games 21-17, 21-14 in 43 minutes. Malaysia fought back in the men's doubles rubber through the Malaysian pair, ranked 13th in the world. They ran away with the first game 11-8 and then edged a tight second 22-20 against Satwik, Ranki Reddy and Chirag Shetty to reduce the deficit to 2-1. The gold medal match is going to probably be decided if Saina Nehwal takes it. I'm just being told that we have another gold medal. India has won another gold medal. This one comes in table tennis. Manisha Malhotra and Suma Shiru, I've got you back. We've won a 9th gold medal at these games. The table tennis team has won a gold. So it's both the men and the women, Manisha, who won gold medals in table tennis. It's never happened before.
Yeah, I mean, table tennis is, again, you know, and as Suma said, that it's important for us as a nation to have new sports that emerge as very successful sports and people to kind of come and break the barriers. And table tennis is one of those sports. And I think it's fantastic. They've beaten people who are way, way, way higher than them. And, you know, this is what's different. And this is what has been changing over the last maybe 3 or 4 games, is that our youngsters now have the belief that they can be people in the world. And we don't go in with this, you know, little shell and say, oh, hope we can compete. We go to yes. win. And if we can keep kind of moving on in this momentum, and I do believe that we can see this happening in an Olympics.